Welcome to once again to my kitchen. Today I am going to show you all chicken Hyderabadi biryani. So here we need 1/2 kg of chicken, boneless or bone, with bones that is optional, whichever way you want. Then we need these ingredients: yogurt 1 cup, salt to taste, 1½ teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of chili powder, 1 teaspoon of shahi jeera, not the normal jeera, but shahi jeera, few chilies, that is optional again, few of mint leaves, we call it pudina, and over there you all say mint leaves, 4 of cardamoms and few sticks of cinnamon, and 2 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Two cups of soaked basmati rice, a good quality basmati rice, that is 2 cup, because we are taking 1/2 kg of chicken. 1/2 fried onions, which is the main tastier for biryani we use. So this is fried onion. You have to chop onions and then fry it in a deep oil till it becomes like this, crispy. Now we will add this all to this chicken. So we will add first. We'll start with salt, turmeric powder, chili powder, shahi jeera, chilies, cardamoms, cinnamon stick, pudina leaves, mint leaves, and this yogurt. And ginger garlic paste. And we are going to mix this together. Nicely mix it together. So nicely mix all the ingredients very well. And transfer it in a pan which you are going to prepare. So here we go. Taken this big pan, you can take your non-stick small pan, mix it very nicely. Now we will use this oil, like maybe the oil which we fried the onions, so you can add like 2 tablespoons of that, and we can add this fried onion to it. Mix it well again. And we'll start the gas. will cover this with this and let it get cook till the chicken is done. Side by side we will cook our rice. So I have taken water, take plenty of water, add oil to it, few drops of oil, few chilies, again is an optional, and few cardamom sticks and salt to taste. So I will add salt for the water. Till then I will try to remove some few pudina leaves and keep. About this biryani, you can either make it chicken biryani or you can make it mutton or lamb. You can use whatever meat you want, or you can add prawns to it. So, and this is Hyderabadi style biryani. So, Hyderabadi dum biryani. So, there is no tomatoes added to it. Let the water get nicely boiled. This is chicken, so it will take very less time to get cooked. If it is mutton or lamb meat, then it will take a longer time. Biryani is such a dish that it doesn't have to be exactly this way. You can add your own aroma, your own style. So this is one of the style, like every state or every country, they will be having their own different ways of making biryanis. It's basically chicken and the rice comes together. So here it goes. It's getting cooked. Nicely getting cooked chicken. So I will show you how it looks. Sorry, my stand is coming on. It's on the way. So this is like this. It's getting cooked. So that side the water is getting cooked. Cover this. Now I will add my rice to the boiling water. Here we go. This is soaked rice. So this is like 80% we have to cook this. Not fully cooked, because again then it will go inside the chicken and then it will be cooked together. So if you want, you can remove all the spices, because if you don't want the spices to be there, so you can remove all this. So just remember, it has to be basmati rice, good quality rice, basmati. So we are using Heritage company. You can have Dawat or whichever is a good quality you get over there. And 80% you have to cook this. First you have to boil the water with all the spices which I have said for you. Cardamoms, green chilies and few cinnamon. And a bit of oil, so it doesn't get stick to each other. The chicken is nicely getting cooked. Very, very nice aroma. Also, there is one more thing that is like you can add kesar. But kesar was out of stock over here due to lockdown. So I am using food color, that is yellow color, and one is orange color. So you can add, you can take some milk, add a pinch of color and you will get this color. Now how you will know it is 80%? So you can check the rice. If it is cooked also, don't worry. Not yet done. Please, please subscribe my channel. Go to YouTube, the link which I am sending. Subscribe it on the YouTube, press the button like if you like the video, and share it to your friends so that they can also learn all this. And please tell those friends of yours to press the button of subscribe, like button, and there is a bell button. The bell button is like this, like it is like a notification for you. You will get it when I upload another video. So then you are like part of this cooking, and whenever I will be adding my videos of cooking, it will be automatically, you will be getting a notification. Share it on FB, share it on Instagram, share it on WhatsApp, so that I get encouraged by this and I get a view by this. Here the cooked rice is almost getting cooked. Still, I will add more hot water. Wow, chicken is awesome. I can do the rice quicker way in pressure cooker, but only thing is like we want a rice which separates from each other. We don't want a sticky rice for biryani. That's why I am doing in this open pan. I wanted to show you all from scratch how to cook rice. That's why I am cooking on this. Now this is done, so I will try to transfer it over here. From the gas. This biryani is sufficient for around 6 people. So if you are making it for 2 people, then 1 cup of rice is enough. So my measurement of 2 cup was this. Okay. Thank you. the chicken gas also now. Chicken is ready and rice is also ready. So here is the chicken. It looks like this. There is little bit gravy which will be used for all this. So now I will add pudina leaves to this. Onions. And this cooked rice. ₹80 cooked rice. And then you spread this nicely. Then I will add this pudina leaves. This color. Sorry. And this orange color. I will use that same fried onion oil to this, or you can add ghee to it. And I will put this first. I'll take this rice water little bit. Just to keep it moist. And then I will add onions, fried onions. And now we will have to cook this for 20 minutes in a slow fire and cover. So I have put the silver foil on the side, so the dum biryani it is called, so the steam doesn't go out. So mostly what most of the chefs, what they do, they will cover up this also with silver foil, which I am going to do. So you take like this and you can press like this. That's why I put it inside this. And then I am going to put this way also. I have already put for the lid, but still I am doing double because I don't want the steam to come out, all the steam from the sides. And I didn't do the wheat atta because when it gets cooked, to remove it, it is very very difficult, and some can handle, some can handle. Thank you. I am trying to do this way. Now put it on the gas and let it cook on slow fire for 20 minutes. Okay, so 20 minutes let it be on slow fire. Once it's ready, I will be back and I will show you the photo also when it gets ready.